In this tutorial, I'm going to be creating this cool text effect. The image I'm using is a stock photo that I downloaded from pexels.com, and I'll put a link in the description below if you want to go check them out and download your own free photos. So the first thing I'll do is right-click to duplicate my layer, and then I'll turn off the background layer. Next, I'll pick my text tool. I'll choose my font style and font size. Then I'll click onto the canvas and type the word love. Then I'll select my pick and move tool and click onto my text corner and drag it to make it bigger. Then I'll click onto my text layer and click onto Effects to add a border. I'll check the border option to turn it on, and I'll choose white as my color and change the size to 1 and click OK. Then I'll click onto the copy of the image I made and drag it to the top of the layers panel so that it's above my text layer. Then I'll click on the view available layers icon and choose apply clipping mask. And I'll turn my bottom layer back on. Then I'll click onto my top layer again, and this time I'll choose the adjust layer icon to the right of the effects icon. I'll make sure the preview with all layers button is checked. Then I'll change the brightness and anything else I want to change. Then I'll click OK. Next, I'm going to make another copy of the background layer, and I'll double-click the eye to the left to turn off all the other layers. Then I'll choose my Select Area tool and select the Smart Brush and make sure that my feather is on 0. I'm going to make a selection of the sky. Now I'll invert the selection so that the woman in the beach and the water are all selected instead of the sky. In this case, it was easier to select the sky and invert it rather than trying to select the woman in the beach and the water. Then I'll click Command or Control C to copy and Command or Control V to paste. This will paste everything except the sky onto a new layer. Next, I'll turn my top two layers back on, and I'll move my cutout layer to the very top. Now I can move my text around, so I'll click onto the text layer, and I'll make sure my pick and move tool is active. I'm also going to right-click on my text layer to convert it to an image. I do this because it's difficult to resize it because the corners of the bounding box are hard to get to. Notice that it removed the white border after converting it, so we can just add the border back again by clicking on the effects icon again and doing the same thing we did the first time. So now I'm just going to save my file. So I'm going to come down here to Save, Share, and I can either save it as a new photo file and then specify my format here in the drop-down.
Or I can choose to save it as a PHI. And then I would just specify my folder here and click Save. So I hope you like this tutorial, and if you do, please give it a thumbs up, and thank you for watching.